Confetti Club, it is Fixie, and July is rolling to a stop. It's sweaty, it's sunny, the beach is beachy, the peaches are peachy, and it is time for everybody's long-awaited video, the Pixie Lux July favorites. No one cares that much. This is entirely fashion and beauty. It is summer that brings out some sort of cherry lips, Lady Gaga, summer boy, My Chemical Romance, summertime, like beast from within me that just wants to lie in a field of dandelions, that wants to pick a sunflower, and that has like a big like red and pink phase again, even though it's not February. So I'm gonna get into it for you guys. I'm gonna start with beauty, because you guys probably have noticed I have been sporting the red lippy a little bit lately. In the past, I for sure have talked about how I hated a red lip on me, but I think that was because the hair color I had, it just didn't work. Like, I think in the Crayola video, I was like, this is bad and I hate it. But guess what? Now I'm blonde, and I was like, I think it's time that I give this a try. Like, whenever I have something and I feel like it doesn't work on me, like blunt bangs or a red lip or any other sort of like fashion beauty thing that I feel like doesn't look good on me, I get determined to find a way to make it work and to make myself like it. And I like this. I did a little 1 AM impulse buy from ColourPop, and I picked up this red lip, which is the one I have been wearing. This is the first liquid to matte lipstick I actually have from ColourPop. I had their ultra blotted lip or whatever, and I really didn't like it, and I had another like stick lipstick I didn't like, but this formula slaps. So this is the ultra satin lip. Did I say it was matte? It's not. So this is their ultra satin lip in the color Kismet. I don't know what that means, but I love it a lot. Here's an uncomfortable close-up on my face, but it's just a perfect orange tone, like strawberry motherfucker red. I feel like pink toned reds are like cherry red and orange tones are like strawberry. Is that wrong? Probably. I don't know, but I love this color so much. I definitely want to try more ColourPop lippies. They do get like that like weird flaky sensation, like starts to kind of feel like it's peeling off your friggin' mouth, but that's after like 6 hours of wearing it. Definitely a favorite. Love this. 10 out of 10. Yes. I have three other beauty faves. It has been a month for my face. So I picked up this highlighter from ColourPop. I actually got two. I was looking for something to kind of dupe the shade Beamin from the Too Faced Life's a Festival palette, because I have used that so much that there is almost none left and it's very sad. So I picked up this one. Hello, sister. And it is just an awesome icy toned highlighter. This scar, by the way, I got from legit doing anime dances with my arms at my computer, and then I smacked it on the desk like 4 years ago. I'm really proud of that. I want everyone to know that I'm like a lethal weeb. So yeah, this one's very nice. I've been wearing this lately. And then probably more excitingly is this one. I got two because I wasn't sure if the other one was gonna be iridescent, which it was not. Whereas this one is definitely like, hello, iridescent duochrome, what's going on? This is shade Over the Moon, and it's a super shock, meaning it's this weird like Play-Doh-y putty type situation. And I don't love the texture of that, but it's the coolest thing ever. I love this highlighter. I've actually been really liking wearing those two together because I feel like this isn't enough glow, but that one isn't enough like weird shifty colors. So together it just makes like a happy little recipe. My last beauty fave is not from ColourPop. However, it is also a highlighter. I actually got this in June and I meant to mention it in my June favorites and then I didn't, so it's rolling over into this one, hee hee. And this is the Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Highlighter Foil in the colors 7-Day Weekend and Poolside. I adore this one. This one's cool too. I like using this more as eyeshadow. I got it pretty much for this one. Hi, how are we doing? And this one. Oh, they're just so pretty and so summery. How are we doing?
we're doing quite well.
So yeah, this has been a very highlighter happy month. It's summer, I'm sweating anyway, I may as well make it look like intentional sweat. And yeah, this is my first Fenty Beauty highlighter. I had another product from Fenty, it was one of their lip products. That has somehow become lost. I'm sure it's just in a purse somewhere. But this is my first like face product from them, and it's as amazing as everyone says it is. I can confirm that the hype makes sense. Moving on from beauty faves to fashion, I only have two others. The wonderful people over at Truffle Shuffle contacted me and they were like, hey, do you want us to send you some things for an Instagram post? And I was like, hell yeah. And I did that a little while back. Again, I feel like I had this in June too, but we're mentioning it now. This is the ever so popular, ever so beloved Polly Pocket Purse. Triple P. Wendy and I were joking, she has her burger purse that she calls a burse, but this is a Polly Pocket purse, but that also starts with P, so I feel like I'm like robbed of being annoying and calling it a purse, because that's what it's already called. This is not interesting. But I finally have this amazing purse. It is so cute. It is so amazing. I have been using it everywhere. I thought it was gonna be annoying because it's one of those boys that like does this, but it's really not that bad. And then arguably the coolest part is that the inside also has like a Polly Pocket print of what the inside of a Polly Pocket looks like. Like, are you kidding me? It's just so sweet. The attention to detail is so cute. And it's also like, it has this like metallic sheen. It's hard to tell because like it's dark in there. And there is one quarter. Hi, jackpot. But yeah, I have been using this nonstop and I love it. They actually just came out with a lavender version with a bow on it, and they emailed me asking me if I wanted, and so you'll probably see me rocking that one as well. But yeah, again, the hype, I believe, is worth it. It's pretty freaking cute. My last fashion favorite is actually one that you guys have probably seen if you have me on Instagram. I finally built up the balls and the confidence to do a beach shoot in a two-piece bikini, and I really wanted to do this. I really wanted to kind of show myself that I could do it, and I wanted to like feel beautiful and do a fun shoot and have it be like a cute little strawberry Valentine summer dream girl cherry, whatever. I had a vision and I really wanted to make it happen, and I didn't want my self-image to like get in the way of that. And anyway, I'm so glad I did. You guys have been so incredibly sweet. Oh my god. Instagram is always just such a fucking love fest. I feel like everyone has different social media where like, ooh, they might get like a couple more spicy boys over on Twitter, or like maybe like this certain platform is always really sweet, or this certain platform is always really sad. Like, Instagram for me is always so pure, and I just want you guys to know that I appreciate that so much. Like, I just like, when I check my comments, I just have the biggest smile on my face. You guys are the sweetest. It's so aggressive. It's just like, step on me, choke me, I'm gay. It's like, it's supportive in the most hilarious way, and I just love you guys so much. And the amount of anxiety that I had over this shoot was like, just, it was a lot. And to have that response be so overwhelmingly sweet and supportive and positive and nice and kind, it meant the world to me. So thank you so much for being nice to me.
I like it when people are nice.
And I'm here to favorite the swimmy suit. Oh, this is funny. Okay, these are both Lazy Oaf. Ha ha ha. So this top is from the Lazy Oaf 2018 Summer Swim Collection. Wah, wah. It is a little off the shoulder, ruffly boy. It is a little annoying because like this one, obviously it only goes over one shoulder. So it kind of like chomps your sorry if you're 12, but like, so like this side is all cute, but then your boob kind of gets like, it kind of like yoink. So basically if you have a bob or two, you might want to just, you know, you might want to order a size up so it doesn't chomp your teat. But I love this so much. However, the bottom for it was so low rise, and I knew that if I tried to put that on my body, I would have a breakdown. Therefore, I did not order the bottom that came with it. I ordered two different red bottoms, and these are just from ASOS. So I got this little high waist. It's a high waist, but it's also high leg. It's one of those ones that like goes all the friggin' way up. People think that girls are like yanking their friggin' swimsuit bottoms up their ass, but they literally just make them like this. But I love this, and I thought it was really cute because it has this little heart buckle. So I was like, hey, it kind of goes with the hearts on the top. Ooh. They will never know this is not the true set. And since I ordered this online, I wanted to be like double, quadruple, super duper sure that I wasn't gonna like get it and then put it on and be very sad. Sorry, this is super real. So I got this pair as well, which is like a big ass high waist bottom, but it goes like above my belly button, so it's like almost too high waisted. It like, I feel like I could pull this whole thing up to my shoulders, but it has a cute little scallopy top, and I got this so I can still wear the top and still have like a look that goes if I'm having like a less confident day. I always want to preach body positivity. I always want people to feel great and be happy and accept themselves and flaunt their stuff, whether that's cellulite, stretch marks, rolls, scars, anything. Or if you're super, super skinny and that makes you self-conscious as well. But I think it's also important to be real that you can preach body positivity and not be perfect, right? I just want everyone to feel good, but I also know myself. I know my past struggles, and sometimes they come up and they bite me back. So I'm really glad that I got two bottoms for days that I'm like feeling a little less great, because I know that I'll feel more comfy and confident sometimes in this that covers up the tum, and then sometimes in this when I can be a hot little summer beach babe dream girl. You know, you gotta give yourself the options, and it's okay. Anyway, yeah, that was my little body posi spiel. It's important to keep in your mind that you know what is good, but sometimes confidence just isn't there. Sometimes eating disorders can come back, and body dysmorphia and bad thoughts can come back, and that doesn't make you a failure. That doesn't mean that you don't believe in body positivity. That means you're a human and that it's okay, and I love you, and fight through it. That being said, I have received a ridiculous amount of adorable fan art of me from that shoot. So today's Future Confetti Club member is newlinu_pix. Sweet newlinu, always supportive, always commenting, definitely has made art and I think has been featured before, who did this wonderful piece from the beach shoot. And I love the straw earrings, I love how big they are, and I love how you drew the eyeballs, and I love how like shiny my skin is. God, I wish. And like the detail in the tattoos, I feel so bad now because when people draw me, they're like, God damn, like your friggin' leg is too complicated. And I'm like, I'm sorry. I love this so much. I think the background's also super cute. I love that the blue heart looks like the sky. I love the hair. I love the straws. I love the tats. And I love you. So thank you so much for your support and your love. I hope you're having a great day. I love you guys all so, so much. And I will see you in the next video, which is not this one because this one is over. Bye!